Hi everyone, my name is Ryan Boyd and I'm from the Developer Relations team here at Neo4j. I want to talk with you today about our latest release, Neo4j 3.4. In Neo4j 3.4, we've made improvements across the entire database system, from scalability to performance to operations and administration. We've also added several new key features to the Cypher query language, including spatial querying support and date time types. Let's talk about the scalability features in Neo4j 3.4. In this release, we've added multi-clustering support. This allows your global internet apps to horizontally partition their graphs by domain, such as country, product, customer, or data center. Now, why might you want to do this? You might want to use this new feature if you have a multi-tenant application that wants to store each customer's data separately. You might also want to use this because you want to geo-partition your data for certain regulatory requirements, or if you want enhanced write scaling. Now let's talk about the four clusters that are shown here. Each of these clusters have a different graph, but they are managed together. They can also be used by a single application with Bolt routing the right data to the right cluster, and the data is kept completely separate. As with all releases, in Neo4j 3.4, we've made a number of improvements to performance. If you look at a read benchmark in a mixed workload environment, you can see that from Neo4j 3.2 to 3.3, we improved performance by 10%. Now, for this release, we've spent the last several release cycles working on an entirely new runtime for Neo4j Enterprise. I'm proud to say that in Neo4j 3.4, we've made all queries use this new runtime, and that improves performance by roughly 70% on average. Now, write performance is also quite important. In our ongoing quest to take writes to the next level, we've been hammering away at one component that incurs roughly 80% of all overhead when writing to a graph. Now, what component it is may not be so obvious. It's indexes. Lucene is fantastic at certain things. It's awesome at full text, for instance. But it turns out to be not so good for ACID writes with individually indexed fields. So we've moved from using Lucene as our index provider to using our native Neo4j index. Now you can see here that we've actually moved to a native index for our label groupings in 3.2, for numerics in 3.3, and now with the string support in 3.4, we've added a lot of the common property types to the new native index. This is what results in our significantly faster performance on writes. Now our native Neo4j index is optimized for graph. It's ACID compliant, allows you fast reads, and as you can see, approximately 10 times faster writes. Now, this is the first release candidate here, and is actually showing you the write performance when writing strings. And you can see here, we're looking at March of this year, and you can see at the point at which we implemented the new native string index, we have approximately a 500% improvement in the overall performance. We've also made a number of improvements around operations and administration of Neo4j in this release. Perhaps the most important is rolling upgrades. Neo4j powers many mission-critical applications, and something many customers have told us is that they want the ability to upgrade their cluster without any planned downtime. This feature enables just that. So if you're moving from Neo4j 3.4 to the next release, you can do it by upgrading each member in the cluster separately in a rolling fashion. Neo4j 3.4 also adds auto-cache reheating. So let's say that you heat up your cache when your Neo4j server starts. When you restart your server the next time, we'll automatically handle the reheating of your cache for you. The performance of backups is important to many of our customers, and they are now 2 times faster. In addition to the scalability and performance and ops and admin features of Neo4j, we've also improved the underlying query language and the query type support. So we've now taken graphs, the power of searching by graphs, and added the power of searching by spatial queries. Our geospatial graph queries allow you to search in a radius from a particular point and find all of the items that are located within that radius. This is indexed and highly performant. In addition to supporting the standard X and Y dimensions, we've also added support so that you can run your queries in three dimensions. Now, how you might use this is totally up to you, but think about a query like recommend a shirt available in a store close by in the men's department. Well, we can take your location and find the different stores, and then once you're in a particular store, you can use that third dimension support, the Z-axis, to find the particular floor and rack that shirt is available in. We've also added a new security feature in this release. This feature focuses on property-level security for keeping that private data private. Property-level security allows you to blacklist certain properties so that users with particular roles are unable to access those properties. In this case, users in role X are unable to read property A, and users with role Y are unable to read properties B and C. In addition to the spatial type, we've also added support for date and time operations. We're going to jump over to the Neo4j sandbox to show you how those work. The Neo4j sandbox has a special Neo4j 3.4 sandbox. That 3.4 sandbox has a guide that guides you through the new date, time, type, and spatial querying support. Now, we have a set of data in here, and let's say that we want to calculate the age differences between certain actors. We can do that pretty easily with a very simple Cypher statement and see Keanu was born on this date, Carrie was born on this date, and here's their age difference. Now let's say that we want to calculate that age difference in a single value here. So in this case, we want to calculate that age difference in days. We can do that just as well. Check it out in the Neo4j sandbox at neo4j.com/sandbox. And to download Neo4j 3.4, visit neo4j.com/download today.